Hello YouTube people, today I'm gonna show you this Cadisen with black dial. This review is gonna be rather negative a little bit, but don't forget that this watch costs less than 100 euros. So how the story goes? You see, previously I had this, well, still have this Cadisen with this incredibly beautiful blue dial, and this watch was running a little bit fast, so I wanted to adjust the movement. And while I was adjusting it, the jewel of the balance wheel just popped off and gone. So I broke this golden movement. Now, this time I chose the one with Miyota movement, but about the movement a little bit later on. So first of all, I was very happy with that blue dial on this Cadisen, and I wasn't expecting anything less from the black dial. I thought it's gonna be very beautiful black glossy dial, and to be honest, I'm really disappointed. This dial looks like it's like just a black paper, absolutely dull, completely boring. Completely boring dull dial. I don't know if you can see that on video, but like on this angle you probably see it's completely dead. This dial looks completely dead, like it's just boring. So, but that's very subjective. Some people might like it. Another thing, I already knew what I was buying, that this Cyclop isn't the best. I mean, it just doesn't magnify anything really. And yeah, okay, whatever. So, but I have a diamond testing tool, which I'm not gonna show you right now. I just, you have to believe me. So I tested this blue Cadisen, and the window and the Cyclop are both sapphire, but with this black dial Cadisen and with this Cadisen, the window itself is sapphire, but the Cyclop is mineral crystal. My diamond testing tool doesn't register anything from the Cyclop, while with this blue one it does register that it is sapphire crystal. So I don't know what's the backstory of this, but looking from my eyes, it just looks like they are just trying to save some money and fool their clients. It's just the way I see. I don't know what's the backstory. And that just doesn't look nice. So that's negative thing number two. What's the negative thing number three? There are overall three things that are negative. You see, I chose in this Miyota movement because there wasn't an option of a Seiko movement. So this, it's the next best thing according to the internet. And people tell nice things about this Miyota movement, and also say that it could be a little bit loud. And that's the third negative thing. You see, this, for example, where is it? Seiko NH35 movement it's not the best looking one. I mean, it's not the best looking thing ever. It's not the prettiest. It looks like some kind of a part from a tractor, which could very well be, because it's very durable, very reliable movement. And this Miyota movement, even though it looks a lot better than Seiko movement, it's actually rather nice looking movement. It has one negative thing. You see, Seiko movement rotor winds the watch in both directions, so it can't really spin freely. But on Miyota, it winds the movement only in one direction, which means it spins completely freely in another direction, which is a little bit annoying, because I can hear those bearings of the rotor are completely dry, like the sound of dry bearings. It just sounds cheap. I don't like the sound. And I had the same problem with this Parnis, beautiful Parnis watch, that the rotor was doing the same thing, spinning freely in one direction and making horrible noises. So I have lubricated with very fat grease the bearings of this rotor, and now several months later this watch is still going strong. It's very accurate and it doesn't make any noise. Also traveled with this watch, I have worn this watch quite a lot, and like several months later, still no problems, no rotor noise, wonderful. So it's fixable problem, but I still have to tell you, if you aren't going to get your fingers dirty and lubricate those bearings, this rotor can be a little bit noisy and annoying, and just the watch on your wrist, it just feels cheap, it sounds cheap, that rotor, but it's fixable thing. So if you are ready to get your fingers dirty, it's not a big deal really. Now let's move on to the positive things. You see, this is a third Cadisen watch that I'm buying, and I'm constantly surprised by the quality of the bracelet. I mean, first Cadisen that I had, blue dial Cadisen, it has a wonderful bracelet. The quality is just wonderful. Soft edges, doesn't sound cheap. Very, very good bracelet. Now this Cadisen with day and date function, a little bit different bracelet. Also absolutely wonderful. Very, very well finished. No squeaks, no rattles. It's just quality product. The same thing with this black dial Cadisen, also wonderful bracelet. Looks impressive, feels impressive. I cannot think of a single bad thing to tell about those bracelets. Another thing about those Cadisen watches, that all these three Cadisen watches have this very beautiful glossy finish sidewall. I haven't had any other watches with glossy finish sidewall. I mean, it's a small thing, doesn't really matter too much, but at some angles it makes this watch look much more alive than it was just a simple brushed finish sidewall. I mean, just look at it, it makes it so much more alive. Even though this dial looks just like a, you know, black paper, this sidewall helps a lot, makes this watch way more alive. It's very nice. I can see those reflections of indexes, and it just, I wish many more watches would make glossy finish sidewalls, because that looks just impressive. It's very nice. And another thing is good water resistance, 50 meters of water resistance, which for me is just perfect. I can swim with these watches, don't worry about that, and they can easily be everyday do it all watches, which is very good positive thing. So, okay, overall, pluses, minuses, still, don't forget the price. It costs less than 100 euros and looks really stunning. I mean, look at this watch from the distance or even a little bit up close. I mean, this is impressive looking watch. And the quality of the bracelet, how it feels on the hand, everything is just fix this rotor, lubricate the bearings, and that's it. You have yourself a wonderful watch. Amazing. So, as an end note, this is not a bad watch after all. Even though Cadisen kind of tries to cheat a little bit with mineral crystal Cyclops. Yeah, but whatever, you know, still for under 100 euros, not a bad watch. So that's where it goes on my website, thomaswatchreviews.com, where I rate watches into different tiers. So that's where it goes, into not bad. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day. Goodbye.